In a world where carbs are your enemy, you need one man to help you fight your battles. That man is Jimmy.
Combating nutrition disinformation and general bull. It's Jimmy Rants. JimmyRants.com.
Everybody in keto is now using Swerve, and it's your turn too. Go to SwerveSuite.com to find a store near you, and it's also available on Amazon.com. Swerve, the ultimate sugar replacement.
What's up, you guys? Welcome back to another Instagram Live. And we're here with another episode of Jimmy Rants. If you're brand new to Jimmy Rants, here's how the show works. Go to JimmyRants.com. You'll see that we start off on Instagram. So go follow me on Instagram. I'm at Living Low Carb Man. That's LivinLowCarbMan. Once you're there, you can engage live in the content, just like Bonnie and Welsh Keto and Joshua and Amy and Keto Stoner, Texas Livingstone. Lots of people coming in right now live. If you missed the live, you can watch it on replay for up to 24 hours. So go follow me on Instagram. If you're not the Instagram type, or if you missed the live or you missed the replay, definitely go check out all the past episodes up on YouTube. Type in a keyword, Jimmy Rants, in YouTube or Google. You will find the show. Finally, we have the best of the best moments of this here show in podcast form. So if you like listening to podcasts, I've done a couple in my life. Go check it out. Jimmy Rants Podcast. It's on Apple Podcast and Stitcher. JimmyRants.com is the website. Today's Jimmy Rants is all about this notion that when people go keto, there's something that hangs them up. So maybe that's you today. Maybe you're watching this today and you're like, you know, I'm trying to do this keto thing, but I just keep getting hung up on whatever it is that hangs you up. So I want to talk about some of those things that are your biggest keto kryptonites. And you know what that kryptonite is. And the thing is, it's different for different people. Some people go on a low-carb, moderate-protein, high-fat ketogenic diet, and they allow their head to get in the way. They allow their desire for carby foods to get back into their head again. So let's say you start keto, you start doing well, you enjoy the bacon, the eggs, the avocado, the steak, the vegetables, the butter, but then in the back of your mind you go, I really want a donut. I really want a bagel with cream cheese. I gotta have my pasta or I'm gonna die. Can I get a witness, anyone? So too many people allow their cravings, their desire for carby foods, to be their keto kryptonite. And if that's you, can I just encourage you, if you're new to keto and you're just starting on this way of eating and you're on day three and you've got a craving for one of those carb-based foods, it's gonna be okay. Be kind to yourself in this time, because it is the hardest time is when you first start, because you still have recollections. You might even still taste in your mouth the taste of that Krispy Kreme donut. You may still have the taste in your mouth of that McDonald's French fry. You may have memories locked in your head of how you felt when you ate those foods. And I'm here to tell you it does get better. And that is a big sabotage for a lot of people early on. It becomes their kryptonite, where they allow the cravings and desires for carb-based foods to totally overtake them. All right, what are some other kryptonites? So if you're just joining us, we're talking about the biggest keto kryptonites. These are the things that you're doing well in your keto and then suddenly everything just changes. So let's go to family and friends and coworkers and all those busybody people telling you what this keto thing is doing to you. And none of them are medical professionals. None of them know what they're talking about when it comes to how keto is impacting your body. And yet they want to tell you all that butter is going to clog your arteries. They want to tell you that, oh, you're eating way too many calories. They're going to tell you that this isn't a sustainable way to eat. They're going to tell you it's kind of funny that you're not eating breakfast with the rest of us. You need to act normal. Stop not eating breakfast. What is wrong with you only eating 1 to 2 meals a day? That can't be healthy for anybody. And you start listening to those people. And those people will try to sabotage you. Those people are your keto kryptonite. Those are the people that are going to prevent you from seeing the success that you deserve on keto, because they're getting in your ear. And so that's a big one. A lot of influence from friends, family, coworkers. But I'm going to take it one step further to the next one. And that's you go to see your doctor and your doctor scares the bejeebies out of you. I just got back from this event in Atlanta, the Adapt Your Life people putting on the event, Dr. Eric Westman and the Adapt team, Glenn and the rest of them. And one of the things that came up was how doctors are specifically scaring patients half to death about heart disease, about obesity, about really cancer, death, when it comes to a ketogenic diet. So they hear a patient is going keto, and the first thing they tell them is, oh, I don't recommend that. Or, oh, you need to take this statin medication if you're going to eat all that fat because it's going to clog your arteries. And all this kind of imagery. And a lot of people, they listen to their doctor and they have the white coat syndrome and they inherently believe everything their doctor says. So maybe your doctor or some other medical professional, or even I'll throw in dietitians and nutritionists that tell you how bad keto is, maybe they are your biggest keto kryptonite because you're believing them. Well, they have the credentials, therefore they should know what is good, what is bad, and they wouldn't lie to me about keto. Wanna bet? So if you are just joining us, we are going over some of the things that might be your biggest keto kryptonite. And I definitely want to hear from you what you think your biggest keto kryptonite is. But here's another big one, guys. And it's going to tick some of you off, but I don't care because I tell the truth here on Jimmy Rants. Your biggest keto kryptonite is you. People get in their own heads. And in a lot of ways, they try to talk themselves out of keto. Even though they want to go on keto, they want to lose weight, they want to get healthy, they want to get all of the good things that come from keto, what they don't want to do is start loving themselves. What they don't want to do is start talking positively. I'm stepping on the toes now, guys. Start talking positively in your head about yourself and about your journey. And I get hundreds of emails a day, you guys. And in those hundreds of emails that I get, I see so much self-hate, self-loathing, sabotage to the hilt when it comes to people and how they respond. Here's how it manifests. It manifests as such angst, such intense stress on their body that they can't lose weight, that they can't see results. And it's self-induced, guys. Now, not all stress is self-induced. There's some people that do have stress because of a bad job, because of family issues, financial concerns. I get all of that. But this specific one, I think there's a lot of people, and I'm gonna again step on toes, but get over it, that like to loathe in their loneliness. They like to loathe in their wanting to self-sabotage. And that sounds so weird because you're like, nobody would purposely do that. I honestly believe there's some people that is so a part of who and what they are that they would rather wallow in it and feel sorry for themselves. And I have people in my life that are that way, and I'm always speaking bluntly back to them. Stop that. Just stop it. Nobody feels bad for you. Just get on the bandwagon. Stop being so loathsome about life. And I speak this from many years of experience of where I've had those feelings of feeling sorry for myself and trying to make others feel bad with me. Not for me, but with me. and bringing them down. And I don't know about you, but we need people that are positive. We need people that will lift us up, and we need to be a part of that lifting up as well. And when you start lifting up and encouraging others rather than feeling that loathsomeness, guess what? That keto kryptonite goes away, and you start being the positivity that some people need. So hopefully this is some things that you're thinking about here today with me, and I definitely want to hear what you guys have to say that you think is your biggest keto kryptonite, because people go keto for a variety of reasons. Most people want to lose weight. A lot of people want to see some improvement in their health. Maybe you have type 2 diabetes. You want to control your blood sugar and insulin levels. All of these things are the reasons why people go keto. But then they run into these keto kryptonites. Here's another one. Just popped in my head. I think people go keto and they never really studied what a ketogenic diet is. And so they go keto, I'll put it in quotation marks, and they have meat and eggs and cheese and butter, and they're just doing it willy-nilly. And then maybe they throw in a few bars and shakes and other products here and there. And then, I'm never losing weight doing this. You ask them about their blood ketone. Well, I'm not testing. Ask them about their blood sugar. I'm not testing that. Like, how do you know you're keto then if you're not testing those things? And so that's another one, you guys. People think they're doing keto, and they're not really doing keto. They're not really doing anything other than they've cut down on their carbs from what they were eating, which for a lot of people will provide benefit. But that could be a keto kryptonite, thinking that you're doing well on your keto journey because you're eating all the keto foods, when in reality, maybe you're not at all keto. And that's the other thing. We all have different ways that's going to get us into nutritional ketosis. For some people, it's going to be a lot lower carbs than others. For other people, you may have to moderate your protein down. Other people need more protein. For some people, the fat intake to satiety, they can't figure out the satiety aspect. So they're overeating on fat, or they're not eating enough fat. There's so many moving parts to this that if you're not following some prescribed plan and trying to figure out what your carb, protein, and fat should be, that's keto kryptonite. And that will fail you and sabotage you every single time. So these are just a few of the things. I could literally do this all day here on Jimmy Rants here today, go over all the various things that could be your biggest keto kryptonite, but I really want to hear what you guys have to say. So welcome in. Thanks for being here on this Sunday. Joshua says, it's not a food, it's not a drink, it's the scale. That is his biggest keto kryptonite. And yes, Josh, I have talked about the scale till I'm blue in the face, as blue as my shirt in the face. And I think the scale is a lying liar that lies, because it doesn't tell the whole story. And people that step on the scale trying to get validation in their keto journey, it is a marker, but I wouldn't even call it the marker. If I was to narrow down what the marker to check on a ketogenic diet would be, more than anything else, blood sugar. Blood sugar. Something that you can test at home, that is. Now, go in the doctor's office, it's insulin. But at home, testing blood sugar. Maybe blood ketones. But blood sugar is decently a good proxy for how you're doing in your ketosis. Not always, but decently well. Too much rides on my success and I refuse to fail. Well, Josh, you have a little lady in your life that you are trying to live for. So get it, man. Alberto said his biggest keto kryptonite is pizza and Krispy Kreme, or it was, not anymore. Yeah, a lot of people love those things. Dory says they don't even taste the same anymore. No, I don't even. There is literally a Dunkin' Donuts right over there, and I don't have any desire ever to put that in my mouth ever again. It's just, ew. Bonnie Lene says pasta is her biggest keto kryptonite. And the great thing about pasta is there's so many substitutes for pasta now, from the miracle noodles to the spaghetti squash to rice cauliflower. I mean, there's all kind of things that you can do. I have no temptations whatsoever, says Bing Xing. Keto has been my lifesaver. And you've gotten to that point. Congratulations, by the way, that you don't have those temptations anymore. But I get it. People first start off, they do have those temptations, and it does make it difficult. Piedmont Keto says Bojangles biscuit. So if you're not living in the South, I don't know if Bojangles is all over the country, but in the South, Bojangles is a thing. And yeah, they have some buttery, cheesy biscuits that people love. So hopefully you get over that, Piedmont Keto. There is a great recipe in the book Southern Keto by my friend Tasha Newton. Go check it out, about how you can make your own ketogenic version of those biscuits. I promise you, they're amazing. Keto cooking with Robin. Cravings do go away over time. Sometimes it's other things that trigger me, though. I don't think a glass of dry wine after a while on keto is a big deal, but I've learned for me, one glass equals bad choices. And that's good that you're so self-aware about that, Robin, that you know that about yourself and that you can adjust your actions as a result of that. Sherry says, giving up fresh baked bread was super hard. Now if I eat a couple of bites, I get so ill. I found out I'm very sensitive to gluten. And that's a big one. People love those things that are familiar, the comfort foods, the biscuits, the bread. If you ever go to like Olive Garden has those breadsticks. Christine always loved those breadsticks. All of those things evoke these emotions. The Outback Steakhouse has that bread. So everybody has their, and Red Lobster with their Cheddar Bay biscuits. Every restaurant has kind of those things that remind us of, ooh, those tasted good. But it was more familiarity than anything. And we now know those things aren't doing us any good. So we choose not to do those, and or we create alternatives to that. Ashton says, oh my God, the big cholesterol scare is enough to make me go wackadoodle. Are you stealing my word, wackadoodle? After years of being there for everyone else, I've decided it's time to take care of me, says Ashton. Yeah. And I think the keto kryptonite part of your answer there is sometimes, especially you women, you're very maternal in this instinct of, I got to take care of everybody else. And if you're taking care of everybody else, you're not taking care of you. And that could sabotage you and be your keto kryptonite too. So kudos to you for recognizing that you are valued as well. Robin says, people need their toes stepped on to make a positive change. Well, I try to do it gently as well. You guys know my style is very encouraging, very positive. I will always speak truth in love to you, because I wish somebody had done that for me many years ago. I wouldn't still be dealing with some of the ramifications of all the bad choices today had somebody spoke truth in love. Usually what happened was they were like, you need to eat a low-fat diet. You need to do this. You need to do that. You need to lose weight. You need to... And none of that was positive at all. So hopefully what you get with this Jimmy Rants, the vibe that you get is nothing but encouragement, inspiration, positivity. And oh yeah, if I step on your toes, I'm going to do it in love. Keto, my success is not seeing change fast enough, quote unquote. Getting discouraged while only looking at the outside results. Yes, that is a big keto kryptonite. It's one reason you hear me talk early and often about not using the scale as the measurement by which you measure your success on keto. The scale is the least interesting aspect of keto, you guys, to see how you're doing. The most interesting is blood sugar. Another interesting one is triglycerides. Another interesting one is blood or breath ketone levels. Those are all signs that you're doing very well. Another interesting one, your HbA1c, which is your blood sugar average over the past 3 months. All of those are really fascinating. Fasting insulin is another interesting one. Most of these, though, you can't, like fasting insulin, you can't do at home. Triglycerides, you can do at home, but it's very hard. Blood sugar, blood ketones,
are all things that you can do at home, and you can definitely track your success much, much better than if you step on that lying liar that lies that I call the scale. Lisa's Healthy Life says, oh man, that was me for years. Little Miss Negative Nothing Works. We've all been there. Couldn't make keto work until I changed my tune and took charge of my happy. Lisa, I am so proud of you because not enough people take charge of their happy. I love that turn of phrase that you use there. And they choose to wallow in whatever negativity that they're in. And I guess I've just grown tired of that mentality because we all have a choice. We can choose what our attitude is about any situation. I mean, I get some really ugliness every single day online, see it every day. Dr. Westman actually posted a picture from the talk I gave yesterday at this event. And on the post of the picture, there were three different negative comments. And if I was a negative person, I could literally wallow in the, oh, woe is me. Why are they saying bad things? But I don't do that. Because at the end of the day, I know who I am. I know who and what I am. I don't need validation or anything from anybody. I'm going to be me regardless. And I'm not going to let anything like that sabotage me. But that's a mindset. That's something that I'm choosing to do. And it's something that I think would help so many people if they took a more positive outlook on how they're doing rather than being negative all the time. It literally wreaks havoc on your health, you guys. So just know that. Alberto says they go keto, and when you ask them, are they measuring ketones, they say, what is that? Yeah. I mean, I think most people that cut down on their carbohydrate intake probably are getting into ketosis, at least a mild level of ketosis. But unless, if you're trying to do keto, and yet you're not testing your ketones, it's almost like driving a car where the gas gauge doesn't work. So you know it's got gas because it's moving, but you're not really sure how much gas is left. You don't really know where you stand when it comes to the gas. And so you're kind of guessing at times. You could stop and fill up gas randomly, but your gas gauge isn't working because you're not testing. It's not working. And I see testing ketones in the same way. Unless you're testing, you really don't know where you stand. You might feel some of the effects of it, but you're not really seeing where you stand. And that can sabotage people because they think they're doing everything, quote, right. I get a lot of questions from my podcast, Keto Talk, to that effect. I'm doing everything right. And then you kind of dig deeper of what they're doing, and they're not doing everything right. So it does make a big difference. Texas Livingston 62 says, staying out of my own head is a daily struggle. I know it is. I know it is. And that's one of the reasons why I come on these Jimmy rants so often, you guys. I'm trying to be that encourager to you that you got to get out of your head. Because it will sabotage you to the level of it just totally will cripple you. And like Superman around Kryptonite, you will just crumble and fall. And it doesn't need to be that way. Onstree says, thanks. I've lost 20 pounds in the last 2 weeks. Wow, that's a lot of weight in 2 weeks. Good job. Be with T 1999, my chronic pain that raises cortisol and causes wild water weight. At least I'm aware of what it is and stop it from derailing my progress. So you have some kryptonite in the form of pain, which raises the hormone cortisol, which also raises your blood sugar and insulin levels, and it causes water weight to kind of shift around. So hang in there. Dealing with that pain is certainly at the top of your list, but it's not a reason to give up on keto. Keto is probably going to help with that in the long term. Grandma Does Keto says, no food triggers anymore, but emotional ones and defensiveness, no matter how well I'm doing, that drives me crazy. Yeah. We get in our own heads. We try to talk ourselves out of this sometimes. It won't hurt this one time. Let me go and I really feel down today. So let me go and have the crappiest of crappy garbage. It's just one time. It won't hurt anything. and it's keto kryptonite. Sherry says, when I first started keto, my main focus was weight loss, but as I've grown and matured through this process, I've changed my thinking. Now health is my biggest priority, and becoming healthy is the number one goal. That's awesome, Sherry. Keep that mentality up, because that will serve you well, and it will prevent you from having keto kryptonite take place. And that's the bottom line in this Jimmy Ranch, you guys, is identify what your biggest keto kryptonite is, and then do everything you can to counter that. And a lot of these things that I've talked about here today that can be your kryptonite on keto, a lot of these things are preventable. You get to make the choice if other people influence you in a negative way, be it your friends, family, coworkers, be it your medical professional, your dietitian, your nutritionist, whoever. You get to decide that. And you get to decide your thoughts of all this, of how you're doing. People get so down on themselves because they do rely on that scale to validate their success on keto. And if the scale's not moving, you've got to figure out there are other ways of measuring to determine how well you're doing on keto beyond your weight. So hopefully some things I talked about here today encouraged you. And that's all the time we have for this Jimmy Rants. JimmyRants.com is the website. As always, head on over to JimmyRants.com. You'll see that the show works this way. We start off on Instagram. All these awesome people that engaged in the content live, they follow me at Living Low Carb Man, LivinLowCarbMan. Once you're there, you can actually engage live. But if you miss the live, I have hundreds of people watch the replay on Instagram. So go follow me there. If you missed the replay or the live, we put all the past episodes up on YouTube. So go follow me on YouTube. Type in a keyword, Jimmy Ranch. You will find the show. Finally, we have the best of the best moments of this here show in podcast form. Jimmy Ranch Podcast over on Apple Podcasts and Stitcher. JimmyRants.com is the website. So until next time, we'll see you then.